Charles Thomas for MuscularDevelopment.com here at the Olympia 2018 Olympia Expo with a very good friend of mine, Swiss coach Patrick Tour. Patrick, how are you doing, mate?
I'm great. I'm doing great. As always at the Olympia weekends, a lot of bodybuilding going on, so I feel at home.
We had dinner last night, and I mean, I don't think you've had any sleep for a while, have you?
No, weeks leading up to the shows and with other, you know, athletes competing elsewhere in the world, it's always difficult to find a long, normal night of sleep.
But I mean, you had two athletes in this contest. You had, I can't say his name, Farias Barrios?
Yes.
Yeah. Do you want to tell us about him?
Well, he's a young Argentinian. He's still a junior, but competing in the open class. Very classical look, fresh face. And it's always fun to work with young athletes and teach them how to come up. And he got second place. We were very happy with the condition and a good starting point for next plans ahead.
Was it 80 kilo he did?
Up to 80 kilo, yes.
So obviously he won the juniors in Argentina, and we had dinner with him last night, and he said that he also then went into the open class, didn't he? I mean, that's to be 23 years old and to be doing that well so young. I mean, I saw the photos on your Instagram and your Facebook, and it's like a kind of physique that you and I like. Very clean lines, very fresh. You know, it's what an amazing future that kid's got.
And especially when you're 23, in your face you have to look like 23.
Yeah.
I see guys at 23 looking like 35.
Yeah. And, good point.
And I don't know, you know, it's something to think about.
Well, I don't think he even looks 23. He looks about 16 in the face. He does. He looks so young.
He looks like a boy.
So let's talk about, you know, your, because I mean, a couple of years ago you had two or three pros. This year you had the sensational Nicholas.
Julio,
I can never say the last name. So obviously this kid has been creating a lot of noise this year. Do you want to tell us about that?
Well, we're not very happy with the call outs. We were hoping to get that first call out and even in the second one to be placed a bit better. But I mean, we have to stay objective and we know we still have a lot of work to do. We still have to find that compromise between fullness and condition, which we have improved, but it's still not there where it needs to be in order to be in that top five at the Olympia. He needs to be crispier on certain body parts and still keep that map, because we just barely made it for the weigh-in. I mean, I don't think anybody else on that height is carrying so much dense muscle as he is. And now we just have to make sure that it matures and can keep those that roundness, but bring a little more details.
I mean, I saw him at the weigh-in, and you said you had real struggles getting him down, didn't you?
Yeah, we had to lose almost 8-9 pounds in the last 12 hours. And it wasn't extremely drastic. I mean, the body responded very well. We hadn't to do anything really crazy. But it's still, it costs energy. It costs, you know.
He looked tired.
Yeah, I mean, he has been on the prep for now almost 6 months,
yes.
Because we did the Portugal show in early July and had to keep going until here. So you know you're working on a body that's already taken a lot of beating. So, but I mean, I'm not complaining. He looked his best ever, and that's what we got. Okay, we have to live with it and try to improve.
When all the athletes was backstage, when everyone was coming out last night, I was actually really excited because I thought he brought his best package so far. And I was like, you must be happy with that, Patrick. And you were like, no, not really.
No, because, I mean, yes and no. You have to be satisfied because you are improving. But on the other side, you have to stay hungry and not be satisfied because you need that to keep improving. If you are just satisfied, oh, we did everything right and we're good and we deserve more and blah, blah, then you're not being objective and you're compromising your future progress.
Well, I think he's had an amazing first year, and I'm so glad that you said to me that you're going to keep him as a 212 for next year, because I think with a bit more back thickness and a bit more going on in that area, I just think keep him as a 212 for at least one more year.
My opinion is that he's going to stay 212 all his life. That doesn't mean that he's not going to try, you know, step in an open show on the way to a 212 show.
To stop him doing what Jose did and get ready for a 212 show, but jump in an open show to see how it had he did it last year at the San Marino. So, okay, well, I was hoping for fifth to eighth. for Nicholas. You think maybe
10th to 12th.
I mean, even top 10 in the first year, that is a fantastic achievement. I think you've done a fantastic job with him, Patrick.
Thank you.
As always, it's always great to see you, mate. And it was nice to have some dinner last night and have some wine. So, okay, with a very good friend of mine, Patrick.
Like
yeah, that's Nicholas. Patrick Tour, I'm Giles Thomas from MuscularDevelopment.com.